UK Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Say client said that there are 50,000 users, and say client in the application say we have these three scenarios like create order, modify order, delete order, okay, and the client has said client or business analyst, okay, said that create order would be executed with 35,000 users, modify order will be 10,000 users, delete order 5,000 users, okay, out of 50,000 it has been said that like this, okay. Now here, say for example, this is in terms of 50,000 users. Say client has said that, one minute. During, say Jan 2013, during Jan 2013, they expected that the 50,000 users might be accessible application on average per day. Okay, during Jan 2013, at that time they estimated that their application will be used by 50,000 users, and that users will be, distribution of the users will be like this. And assume during the Jan 2014, say they estimated that there will be 1 lakh users. Okay, there will be 1 lakh users, and this will be it will be double of the numbers. When say they estimated that it will be double of the numbers. Say it is something like it is basically say. During this time they assume that 5,000 users, and during this time they assume that 1 lakh users are there. So the distribution of the users is being like this. I mean, it is being doubled from 1 year on year. Say they assume, they also find out that the distribution of the users will be doubled year on year. Okay. So here from 1 year to the other year, say the distribution of the users has been increased. It is going to be doubled over here. Okay. In this case, say this is a kind of a without percentage mode. Say if you are following a without percentage mode, what you have to do, you have to open your scenario, and as from year to year this number is been changing here. Okay, earlier we had a 50,000 users, you had these numbers. During this one, again, if you want to test your performance testing, what you have to do, you have to open your scenario, you have to update these numbers. This is all without percentage mode. Say for example, if you have a percentage mode. So for example, if you have a percentage mode, what you would have say here, you would be saying that 70% and some 20%, 10%, like this. So here in future, you don't need to touch this scenario here. In future, if you would have mentioned with percentage mode, okay, you don't need to touch your scenario. What you have to touch, you just need to touch this number only. You just need to upgrade this number. You don't need to touch at the virtual user level. Now see here, it might be 50,000 users. It might be 1 lakh users. Okay, it might be any number of users. It's simply driven by a percentage. So in total, it is going to take the percentage. Automatically, the scenario will decide in total what is the percentage that you want over here. Okay, so every time at the virtual user level, you don't need to update the numbers out here. Okay, it just this number you need to update. Now if you see here, say here currently there are 10 users. By default, it took 10 users, and the 10 users distribution is happening like this. Say for example here, I'm expecting that this is a 70%. Okay, so this becomes 70 and this becomes 30 automatically. And moreover, it means out of 10 users, 7 users will be worked on the special scenario, and remaining 3 users will be worked on the special scenario. This special script. Okay. So 70% of the users, it might be 10, it might be 5, it might be 20, it might be any number. In that number, that distribution will happen like this. Okay. 70% of the users will work on the special scenario, and 30% of the the users will work on the special scenario. Okay. So which is preferable? Which is preferable? With percentage mode, without percentage mode? If that is correct, Suvarna, and that is correct, Revan. Yep. It is preferable to use with percentage mode, okay? So it is better to use with percentage mode over here. Okay? Yep. I know it's with percentage mode, it is preferable to use with percentage mode. Because you don't need to touch your scenario anytime. At the group level, at the V users level, you don't need to touch your script. Automatically it is going to distribute based on the percentage. And however, say if this whenever this number changes, say if this number also going to change, maybe in that case without percentage mode may be good. But say in general, most of the times, the user load will be distributed based on the percentage. Okay, so generally client or business analyst say that out of X users, eighty percentage of the users will work on one functionality. Some 5% users will work on one functionality. Like that, they will be giving some numbers over here. Okay. So we'll be mentioning these numbers. We'll be mentioning these percentages over here. Fine. This is all about with percentage mode. Okay. Now, however, during execution, we'll try to run. Yeah, see, we need to mention some load generators, and moreover here, let me mention some 4 users only. And here, let me mention a load generator. Listen. It is localhost. Did you all remember? Localhost means which is going to generate the load from my machine. Now everyone observe. First of all, there is something called different statuses of a virtual user. Okay, so first it will be in down. Why it is paused? But it is directly saying that paused, and directly it comes to the special stages. I think it does not have anything. Probably we'll do something. We'll create two scripts. Everyone agree? Now we'll create two scripts on this dummy application, on the sample application. And we'll try to have some transactions, okay, so that we can understand practically all these things. 1 minute. I hope everyone of you remember how to open the sample application. But before this, we need to start a server, right? Oh, I think I had an issue with my browser, right? one minute. Yes, last class I have used Islam's machine. We'll give you a try for one more time. But however, if you observe, you know, among these number of users. Now if you look at here, we said 70-30, so here I have mentioned 4 users. So this 4 users distribution, I mean among the 4 users, 3 users is being allocated for the first group over here, and the 1 user is being allocated for this group. However, here now it is not 75 and it is not 25, but still it is given more preference for this. Because if you mention here, say if it is going to be 2 and 2, what will happen, it is going to be 50% and 50%, right? So that is the reason three users is been allocated for this particular scenario and one user is been allocated for this scenario here. So as I said, percentage is preferable. So when you try to create a new scenario, everyone observe where to choose a scenario here. I mean where to choose, let me say this particular scenario. Now everyone observe, this is the place where you need to select the use percentage mode. Okay, by selecting the manual scenario, this is the place where you need to select the percentage mode without percentage mode. I think Pamela, you were asking this question. While creating a scenario, you need to select, if you want to have a percentage mode, you need to select a respective checkbox. If you don't want to have a percentage mode, just unselect this. It's still opening. Why is it loading solution? Now let me see the record over here. slow here. Even though now I am installed on my local machine, which is having 6 GB RAM, still it is slow. I think that is as we have open controller. Islam, don't mind. Shall I take your machine? Yep. No, finally I got it. 1 minute. Yep. Let us give it a try, then we'll look into that, Islam. Yep. Actually here I need Islam, do you have any two scripts which is having some transactions so that I can clearly explain the controller, how can we make use of controller with the analysis, so I can show how exactly we'll be using controller and analysis practically. It seems it is not recording. Basically, it is not recording. It is just saying two numbers only. No, I think it has some browser issue. So let me give it a try. Yep, no use. It did not recording anything. I think that is a problem with the. Yeah, fine. Let me make Islam as presenter. Islam, can you accept it? Can you give me the control? Okay, I think I got it. 1 minute. 1 minute. Okay, it seems to have opened analysis. Now see here. Let us take a new scenario. Can I save it, Islam? Yeah, go ahead. If you want to save, you just save. Yeah, fine. Now, everyone agreed, let me take a manual scenario. And here, Islam, can you take any two scripts which is having some transactions? Great. Yeah, thank you, Islam. Now everyone agree here. So here we open in a percentage mode. Say here we have two scripts. Okay. Now say for example here, as we understood that it is better to select the run until completion. So I'm selecting this one. Now here here it is saying that now say for example I want to execute this particular script with say some 70%, some 75%, and automatically the remaining one will become 25% over here. Okay? Yep. And you have to maximize your go-to meeting window. This is the maximum size. Yep. Now then here, what you have to do over here? No, Now see here, let me say here the total users, let me say some 6 users over here. Okay. Now see here, the 6 users will be distributed to these scripts over here. So 75% of 6 users means how much? I think it is it might be 4 or it might be 5. Now see here we have to mention localhost. Now see here we are done with the scenario, configuration of scenario. Now go to run. Now here click on start scenario. Okay. And here results directory are let me say no here. I mean see here we can mention our own results folder over here. Okay. Let me say generally we'll be giving with some time. Here it is. Let me say 08/02/14. Okay. And giving timestamp, let me say _1. Now here by default it is in a down stage and pending stage. Init basically here, this is a place where it will actually getting into the application over here. Okay. So actually ready is like whenever the user is get ready with all the things, it will run. Here this is the run is the actual place where it is going to execute. Here it is actually the actual execution will happen in the run. Okay, mainly here the main status would be run by default. I mean actual execution will happen in the run, and whenever the user get passed, it will come to this passed status. If the user failed, it will come to this failed status. And say here while executing, if the user faces some error issues, it will come into error. Okay. And gradual exiting in the sense, say for example, if you suddenly say stop over here, say you are executing, you are suddenly saying stop, now the users will come into the gradual exiting. Can you all see here? Say, I right away want to stop my scenario, stop now. It will directly come into stop, exiting and stop. Okay. Now let me explain about these three, basically gradual exiting. In the sense, when you are executing your scenario, say, you have done some mistake or generally whenever you find so many issues, say for example within some 5 to 10 seconds if you observe so many issues here in the errors page, in that case you have to stop your execution, because it seems something went wrong. Say if it is a problem with the server, if suddenly some user has been increased, say if it is applying so much of load on the server, That is the reason it might be throwing some errors here. What I'm saying here, if the errors are generating very frequently, maybe say within 5 to 10 seconds, say if it is generating so many errors, just stop the execution. Don't go over the execution here. It is a tip. It is a best practice. Are you able to follow over here? Is it clear? I'm saying that if there can be errors, but I know 1 or 2 errors is okay, or so many errors are also okay. But if the errors are suddenly increasing, okay, within a fraction of some time, say if the errors are suddenly increasing, in that case it is better to stop the execution. Don't go for the execution. There might be a problem in your scripts, or suddenly there might be some problem that is throwing from the server. Okay, this is one of the tips that you have to remember. One point. Second point is, I'm saying, say you are executing your scripts, and when you click on stop, basically it will come into the gradual exiting. Gradual exiting in the sense, say for example, one user is logged into the application, and in the middle of the process of, one user is middle of creating an order. So gradual exiting in the sense, it will try to complete that creating order and it will formally log out over here. Say for example, here you have mentioned a script with some 20 iterations over here. Everyone please observe my statements, or please clearly try to understand my statements. Say there is a virtual user group. If you all remember, in a virtual user script, we can mention some iterations. Did you all remember that? Did you all remember in a virtual user script we can keep some iterations? Did you remember? Yes or no? In a virtual user script, did you all remember? We can keep some iterations. Okay. Say, for example, here. Say here you are executing for 10 users. Okay. You have mentioned 75 users. Maybe some 8 users will work on this particular scenario over here. Okay. So say in the particular virtual user script you have mentioned some 5 iterations. So each user will execute for 5 times. Okay, because you are saying that some 75% of users will execute 5 iterations over here. So in between, if you suddenly click stop over here, in between while executing the script, if you click on stop here, the user will get into the gradual exiting. Say one user is executing the third iteration. So user will try to complete that particular third iteration, and after completion of the third iteration, it will come out of this, it will come to exiting, and it will be stopped over here. Okay. So say if the user is in the middle of a particular iteration, or user is in the middle of some particular task. Okay. It will not, when you click stop button, it will not directly come out of that particular server. It will come out once it completes its current task. That is the reason it is mentioned as gradual exiting. Is that clear? First of all, do you understand that one, gradual exiting? Any questions on this gradual exiting? Any questions? Now, exiting in the sense, say user is already gradual exiting, but still generally here, say if you are executing for 100 users, and each user would be in some middle of some task. So to complete that particular complete task may take some 5 minutes, maybe 10 minutes, right? Say for creating a booking order, say it is going to take some 2.5 minutes. Okay. Say still you don't want to continue with that gradual exiting also, because as I said, gradual exiting in the sense, user in the middle of some task. Okay. You click on stop. So user will try to complete that particular task, or user will try to complete that particular iteration, and after that it will come out of it. So still you don't want to do that. Still you don't want to continue with that execution. Still you want a situation like you want to come out of that particular, immediately you want to, user has to come out of that particular server immediately. You don't want to even complete that particular iteration. In that case, what you can see here, there will be stop button will become stop now. Now see here, everyone up here, everyone closely up here. What happened? And it seems there is some problem here. What is this? Here, can you all see here it is saying that even I have mentioned I think 6 users, right? I think I have mentioned 6 users, but it is saying that CPU usage is more, it is saying more usage by the virtual users. 1 minute, let me change it test. Instead of 6, let me say. Let me say 6 over here, sorry, 2 users, and let me say 1 user, and here let me say 50. So I'm saying 2 users, 15 seconds. What is happening? One minute. Let us take a new scenario. Let me say no for this. Now, Islam, can you select two scripts? you take good scripts. Are those two scripts good scripts? I mean, which is having some translation without some errors. Okay, it seems yes. Okay, fine. Let's see. Now everyone is there. Two users are there. Let me say stop. Okay, when I say stop, it is directly stopped. Fine. 1 minute. They would have been, they should be in run mode. When the user comes into run mode, we'll click on stop over here. Now see here, everyone over here, let us wait, it has to become 15 seconds. Yeah. Now see here, I'm clicking on stop. Now can you all see here, now it is stop now. This button becomes stop now. And currently it is gradual exiting. Okay, even in gradual exiting also, it is going to perform some transactions over here. Can you all see here? Can you all over here? Even in this gradual exiting also, transactions are increasing. It means user is still executing some things. So user is trying to complete the current task, current iteration. Okay. Say no, I don't want to do that. I still want to exit from this. What you can do here, you can click on stop now. Okay. If you click on stop now, this gradual exiting users will come to this exiting. Okay. And then stop them. So if I say stop now, it will come to exiting. No, sir, it is coming into the exiting and then stopped. Okay, exiting in the sense, user underscore end. I mean, user will try to this exiting in the exiting phase. Basically, it is trying to execute the user underscore end. Okay, and here it seems, there is a problem in your machine, Islam. Here, every time, you are getting this kind of a message. One minute. Let me see here. Don't do anything, 1 minute. Why it is saying CPU usage? Did you open any other things, Islam? Why it is saying even for 2 users it is saying this particular message? Are you executing any other scenario over here? Can you close the other things? Yep. Just keep only this one. And I hope in your in this particular machine you have some memory. You have some space. Just close everything. Even close the analysis. Now, however, see here, as of now, you can ignore this particular errors. It's because it seems kind of a memory issue. Okay, So this is how scenario is going to execute, and moreover, while executing, if you come across any error, basically here, you know, it is going to show errors. In this case, actually, it is a problem with the this one memory issue. Okay, memory issue in the sense, you know, it could not find some space over here. That is the reason it is showing 80% of the users is being, I mean, 80% of the memory is being consumed by the load generator itself. Okay, but however, here, you know, these errors can be ignored. But say whenever you are executing a script, say if you come across an error, so you can look into this errors over here. You can click errors, and here in the place of this view users, it is going to talk about the which user and what is the script. If you click on the script, basically it is going to show in which script we have got an error over here. Currently it is not because of the scripts. Evidence here, whatever the errors that now we are able to see here, these are not the errors because of the scripts. Okay, that is the reason it is as part of script it is saying zero. Okay, so here say if it is a part of the script, you just click on this particular script, it is going to show, talk about the script, and you can pinpoint where exactly in which particular script, at which particular action, okay, it is going to talk about the script name and action name, even the line number, and it is going to tell me the what is the exact error. Okay, so whenever you got an error, you click on this an error, and here it is going to show list of these scripts and their respective actions and even the line number in the particular action at which line it is getting failed. Okay, so now after you find that, you need to probably look into that. I mean, say is that problem with the correlation issue or relay server issue and all. Okay, and that is one thing. I mean, if you while executing, if you want to dig into the issues, this is one of the this is one of the source that you can dig into the issues over here. And if you all remember, I think in the last class itself I said here in this particular options, which option that we have discussed, by using which options we can find the issues over here. Among these options, which option we are going to use? Did you remember? If you all remember, we have discussed something called show view user log. Okay, which is going to talk about the view user log. And moreover, if you all remember, we understood that this log is basically we need to configure the runtime settings for the scenario, and here we need to select the generate the log only whenever there is an error occurs. So whenever there is an error occurs, you can right click on this particular view user. Okay, you can right click on this particular view user, and you can say that show view user log over here. So it is going to talk about that particular view user log. Okay, so basically whenever there is an error occurs while executing your scenario, whenever there is an error occurs, what you need to basically you can just forget about this past. Whenever it comes into the failed status or error status, in that case what you have to do, you need to right click on that particular user and just say that show view user log, which is going to show the particular log. I mean, at that particular, as I said here, it is going to generate the log whenever there is an error occurs. So you can observe that particular log, and you can look at this particular errors, and based on these two things, you can figure it out what could be the issue over here. Okay, and then you can fix it. So basically, as I said, controller is basically it is for the just execution. Okay, now I'm still wondering why it is showing these errors. Can I close this one? No, don't close the GoToMeeting. No. If you close GoToMeeting, you will be logged out from here. Yeah, fine. However, as of now, just ignore these particular errors. Okay? Now, everyone over here, now let us freshly execute this particular scenario. Let me say reset. Let me close controller also. No, try to open freshly. Yep. Can you select two scripts? Now everyone over here, now we'll practically we'll execute this Python script. Okay, earlier we were stopping the script in between to understand that particular statuses. Okay, now here we'll try to give a new results name over here. Yep, here we did not mention this local host over here. And here we will give a new resource name, I mean this one.
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.